Welcome to this spoken tutorial on item submission in DSpace. In this tutorial, we will learn to submit an item in the collection and check the item submission status. This tutorial is recorded using Ubuntu Linux OS 18.04, DSpace version 6.3, and Firefox web browser. However, you may use any other web browser of your choice. To practice this tutorial, you should have a working internet connection. Install DSpace 6.3 on your system. Tomcat service should be running. Created a collection in the community. Have submitter's authority in the collection. If not, then please go through the prerequisite tutorials on this website. To follow this tutorial, you should also have knowledge of library science and familiarity with Dublin Core metadata standard. This tutorial assumes that you have done the immediate previous tutorial assignment in this series. If not, please do so before proceeding ahead. The article and the metadata used in this tutorial is available in the code files link on this tutorial page. Please download and extract the files before practicing. An item is a bundle of digital files such as article, book, report, etc., and the respective metadata. By default, DSpace is configured for Dublin Core metadata standard. Files uploaded as a part of item are also known as bitstreams. Items are hierarchically located below the collection. In this tutorial demonstration, I will submit a PDF file of an article along with its metadata. So collectively, an article and its metadata constitutes an item in DSpace terminology. Now, let us proceed to submit an item in the collection using submitter's authority. Open a web browser and go to the DSpace interface. Log in to DSpace with the submitter's account. We had already created this account earlier in this series. I will log in with my submitter's account. We are now in the submitter's My DSpace page. Click on the Start New Submission button in the My DSpace section. Next, click on the drop-down arrow adjacent to the collection field. A list of collections will be displayed. These collections appear with the respective hierarchical community and sub-community. Now select articles from the collection list which appears as IITB Digital Library, Electrical Engineering, Articles. Then click on the Next button below the collection field to proceed further. The item submission form opens up. In this form, under the Describe tab, we will fill the metadata of the item. Please note that all fields marked with an asterisk symbol are mandatory. You can leave the other fields blank if you do not have those data. Based on my metadata file, I will fill the following fields: authors, title, date of issue, publisher, and citation. If an item has multiple values for a field, you can add it by clicking the Add More button. For example, if we have more than one author for an item, click on Add More button to add other author names. As an identifier, any standardized code can be used. DSpace provides identifier options like ISSN, ISBN, ISMN, URI, Government's Doc Number, and others. Choose the appropriate option from the drop-down list in the Identifiers field. Then type the unique identifier number available for the file to be uploaded. I have selected URI and entered the DOI, that is Digital Object Identifier, of the article. Select type of the item from the drop-down list. I am going to select article. Items may have multiple digital files of different types. For items with multiple digital files, we can select multiple types. To do so, you may have to hold down the Ctrl or Shift key on your keyboard. Select the language of the file to be uploaded for the item. As my article is in English, I am selecting English. Then click on the Next button at the bottom right corner. In the second page, I will fill the keywords and the abstract as shown here. Leave the rest of the fields as blank. Click on the Next button at the bottom right corner. The next section is Upload a File section. Click on the Select a File or Drag and Drop Files link to upload the files. A pop-up window named File Upload opens. Browse to the directory where the file is on your computer and upload the file. The upload may take some time depending on the size of the file. The Files to Upload table shows the uploaded files. On successful file upload, a green tick mark symbol appears next to the file name. Type any description text for the uploaded file in the description field. I am leaving this as blank for now. If you want to upload multiple files, then repeat the same steps as shown above. Now click on the Next button at the bottom right corner. Submit File Uploaded Successfully section shows the details of the uploaded files. In this section, we can cross-verify the uploaded files. Wrongly uploaded files can be removed by clicking on the Remove button adjacent to the file name. We can add files for an item by clicking on the Add Another File button below the table, and then repeat the file upload steps. Once the uploaded file is cross-verified, click on the Next button at the bottom right corner. The next page, Submit Verify Submission, displays the metadata which we have entered so far. At this stage, we have entered Dublin Core metadata and uploaded a file for an item. Check carefully for any mistakes in the entry and correct them if any. I noticed that I have made a spelling mistake in the title. To correct the title, click on the corresponding Correct One of these buttons. The Describe section of Item Submission Form opens up. Locate the spelling mistake and correct it. Then click on the Next button at the bottom right corner. Click on the Next button repeatedly until you reach Submit Verify Submission page. Observe that the title is now updated. Once you ensure that everything is correct, click on the Next button at the bottom right corner. In the DSpace Distribution License page, read the distribution license. If you agree with the terms in the license, then click I grant the license button at the bottom. Now our item is successfully submitted. Next, let us proceed to check the status of the submitted item. To do so, locate the link Go to My DSpace and click on it. We will be redirected to the My DSpace page. We can see that the submitted item is in the workflow process. That is, the submitted item is in the task pool of the reviewer. Let's now learn how the reviewer gets notified. A notification email is sent to all authorized reviewers of the respective collection. Let us proceed to cross-verify the email sent to the reviewer. Log in to your reviewer's email account. -dspace.u4@gmail.com. Here is the email with the subject, DSpace, you have a new task. If the email is not seen in the inbox, then it could be in your spam folder. Otherwise, recheck your internet connection. Let us open the email. It shows details of the submitted item like title, collection, submitted by. The reviewer can view a new task using the URL provided in the email. So now we have verified the notification email sent to the reviewer. Switch back to DSpace. Let us log out this user from the DSpace interface. This brings us to the end of this tutorial. Let us summarize. In this tutorial, we learnt to submit an item in the collection and check the item submission status. As an assignment, submit an item in the article collection of Electrical Engineering sub-community. For uploading an item, use the following article and metadata file from the code files. jlpea-article.pdf, jlpea-article-metadata.txt. The video at the following link summarizes the spoken tutorial project. Please download and watch it. The spoken tutorial project team conducts workshops and gives certificates. For more details, please write to us. Please post your time queries in this forum. Spoken Tutorial Project is funded by MHRD, Government of India. DSpace Spoken Tutorial Series is funded by the National Virtual Library of India, Ministry of Culture, Government of India. The script and video for this tutorial was contributed by Pankaj Patil from IIT Bombay. And this is Nancy Verkey signing off. Thanks for joining.